Welcome to Norfolk Perspective City Slice. I'm Bob Batcher, and we're going to be talking about play.
That's right.
That is so cool. Jennifer Caldwell, we're going to play?
We are. We always play, but...
Well, no, we don't. I mean, life is serious. It's busy.
Well, you should always play. At least one day a week.
That sounds like cool. Now, okay, Jonathan Chapman, you're a recreation specialist, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you're Mr. Fit, too, though.
I like to think I am.
So are we talking fitness and exercise, and are we talking play?
It includes fitness and exercise, but play is really just being outside, moving around, having fun. It can be structured or unstructured. The most important part is that you're moving and that you're enjoying the movement that you're engaging in.
It's that easy.
It's that easy.
So why do we make it so hard?
We don't. We offer ways for you to play every day.
You don't make it hard, but we make it hard on ourselves.
That's true.
We come up with all kinds of reasons why we can't play. We don't have time, right?
That's mm-hmm. true.
I speak from experience on that.
Yes. And what have you learned?
I've learned that through fitness and through really focusing on my health, I can have more fun, and that's it right. is easier.
Mm-hmm. That's
35
right.
35 pounds.
And we're here to help you. I know. We're very proud of you.
Well, you know, but, you know, okay, but for how long were you on that sofa kind of harassing me out of this chair?
It took a while. It really did take a while. But once you get out of the chair and you get up and moving, you realize how easy it is. And that's why we're here today, because we have an event coming up.
I know it.
And hopefully that will get you or others like you that haven't really gotten up yet. Hopefully it'll get you off the sofa.
Well, because, I mean, I look at, okay, I won't jump rope. Okay, I haven't figured that one out yet. I have a whole admiration for people that can jump rope. They'll be jumping, roping at this thing?
There will. Okay. Among a ton of other things.
Like what?
So, Jonathan, you want to take the lead on that?
Well, Playday event is really going to encourage both families and children to get outside and just have fun. And so we'll be teaching the children a lot of the games that you and I and Jennifer played when we were little. Before video games,
you
and
mean,
before cell phones, and
before all of those things. The thumb?
That's right.
Beyond the thumb. The games that strengthen your entire body. And so we'll be playing, of course, some red light, green light, some Mother May I, some Duck Duck Goose, which I heard you're pretty fond of.
Yeah, as long as I'm not goosed, yeah, I'm okay.
some hopscotch, some foursquare. I mean, just a ton of games.
You're saying these games like you know them.
Absolutely.
Really?
I know I look young, but I'm not as young as I look.
Okay. Sack races?
Sack races.
Really?
Absolutely. Kick the can.
Really?
Stick ball?
Yeah.
Stick ball.
Cool. Dodgeball?
Dodgeball is kind of touchy.
That one's kind of gotten out of control.
We would have to get people to sign waivers for dodgeball.
What?
Really? Just in case.
I've seen her play volleyball. Waivers on that, too. Trust me.
Jennifer has a pretty mean spike.
Here we go.
But that's the whole point of the event. Is it's Play Day, you know, 2013 on September 21st at the Tarrallton Community Center. And it's just to get families out, get them moving, and show them that it doesn't have to be anything, you know, hard. It doesn't have to be anything expensive or highly technical. Just get outside and play. It can be jump rope. It can be tug of war. It can be tag or red light, green light. It's super mm-hmm. easy. Just get out and get moving.
Now, how does red light, green light work? I forgot that one.
You designate the one person to be the it for the game, and everybody else lines up on the opposite end of the field, and then the it turns around, and when they say green light, then everybody else starts running towards the it, and when they say red light, everyone has to stop. And if you're still moving after the it says red light, then you're out, or you have to go back to the starting line.
Oh, okay. So you had to listen.
You do.
Ooh, that's a novel concept.
And not only are we playing red light, green light, but we are taking red light, green light to the next level this year at Play Day, and we are trying to break a Guinness World Record for the largest game of red light, green light. So we really need folks to come out and help support us. We need about 800 folks in the game participating at the same time to break the record. So,
whoa.
Yeah, this is a call to all of our neighbors and friends to come on out. Simple game, quick and easy. We just need you to participate so we can put Norfolk down in the history.
So between
books.
Now and the 21st, practice listening.
Yes.
Right.
And it's easy. You know, you don't have to really run. You can just walk if you want to play. So mm-hmm. it's nothing. It's something that anyone of any age or any skill could do, could participate in.
Now, is there a time on the 21st you're going to be doing that?
Yes.
Because the event is from 10 to 2, right?
Right.
Yes.
The actual attempt is going to be designated for the 1 o'clock to 2 o'clock hour.
Okay. And we will ask you to get there a little bit in advance, because with 800 folks, we have to do a little coordinating. So
carpool.
Absolutely.
Cool. Now, you know, I just realized what I said. Practice between now and the 21st. And again, I want to go back to that whole concept of
You don't
playing.
Have to practice to play. You just have to get out and do it.
Yeah. And we've got a great place to do it. And you, how many parks do we have? I mean,
we have over 134 parks, playgrounds, and open spaces in this city. So we have a ton of areas for people
so
to play.
So you don't even
right
really have to wait till the 21st
right.
from 10 to 2 at Tarrallton to do it.
Absolutely not.
Sure don't.
Walk up to your neighborhood park.
That's it.
And none of we don't have the merry-go-round things anymore. So there's nothing scary in a park, right?
No.
And is there some place we can go to get all this information?
You sure
hear
can.
About all this stuff?
You can go to our website at Norfolk.gov/RPOS for recreation, parks, and open space. You can go to your local rec center and pick up a copy of the Good Times magazine. The play day information is the back cover, so it's got all of the details
there
for you. Or you can go to Facebook.com/NorfolkRPOS and get all the details there.
Okay, I'm going to put you on the spot. Because you kind of flipped over the cover real quick, but that is a precious little girl on the cover.
She is. This is Mika, and Mika is one of our participants at our Therapeutic Recreation Center, which offers programs and services for individuals with disabilities. And this photo was taken at our annual Day for People with Disabilities, which is a service provider fair that we host in partnership with the Virginia Zoo each summer. So, yeah, I love it. I couldn't pass up putting this on the
That's
cover because it
to
just...
die for.
It is. It's fantastic.
Now, but that also brings up that we're, I mean, and kind of broadening off from the Tarrallton Rec Center, I mean, there's a variety of types of programs for all types in our community, right?
That's right. We really offer a full spectrum of recreational programming for all ages. Our swim classes start at 6 months, and then we have programs up through senior adult. We also offer therapeutic recreation for individuals with disabilities, art, music, dance, fitness. We pretty much run the whole gamut of anything you could want to do for fun in this.
So if you want to use one of the rec centers, what kind of rules and regs do you have to go through?
So to use a rec center, you just go to your local center and ask to get a facility use ID card. It's $10 a year for children.
Wait a minute, you sure you got that right?
$10 a year.
A year?
Yep, you buy the card, $10, and you can go to any event at the rec center for the entire year. And not just that rec center, it gets you into all 18 of the rec centers and 4 swimming pools.
Are you
so
sure?
$10 a year, 20 for adults, so a little bit more expensive for adults, but it's really the best deal in town for recreation.
Wow. Now, I've been going to the Fitness and Wellness Center, which is a little different.
It is a little different.
So that's got another membership to it.
It does. Yes, the Fitness and Wellness Center is more of like a full-service gym-style facility, so that is membership-based, and the fee structure is a little differently there.
And then with the classes that are listed in Good Times, you can have an opportunity to sign up for those, and those are additional costs, too. But they're great classes.
And they're great classes, and they are priced very, very reasonably. So definitely check them out. They're all listed in the Good Times magazine, and we are registering right now.
And, Jonathan, I'm going to say this. Those classes will teach you to play.
That they will. They'll teach you a different way to play.
You can get away from this.
Absolutely.
Okay, what's your favorite game?
My favorite game?
Yeah.
Video game or game?
No, video game. Good game.
My favorite good game is actually dodgeball.
Really?
I enjoy dodgeball.
Wicked dodgeball player.
Yes, sir.
Huh? So we're not doing that on the 21st.
No, not on the 21st. I don't know. Maybe.
What's your favorite game?
Oh, goodness. Well, I'm a wiffle ball girl myself. We might not be playing that on at play day, but wiffle ball is one of my favorite pastimes.
Is that like baseball except with the ball,
white
the holes
ball
in.
With the holes? Yeah.
Why do you like that?
It's a fun game, and you don't have to be a pro baseball player.
Are you
to get
good
out
at?
And play
you must
ball.
Be good at it.
I think I'm pretty okay at it, but if you ask people I play against, they might have a different opinion.
Is that why dodgeball is your favorite? Because you're good at it?
I like to think I'm pretty good at it. I'm pretty good at dodging and throwing. And catching.
But now a lot of our are doing coaching, and like I know that there's some staff over at the fitness center that do volleyball coaching.
That's correct. That we kind of a lot of our staff members, they're recreation professionals. They love what they do, so they split their time. They not only work at the centers, but a lot of them do volunteer to coach recreational league sports, football, basketball, volleyball. So
what part of work do you have during the day? It's not play, right?
Just paperwork. You know, that's pretty much the only part of work that's associated with my job, and that's one of the things that I love about it the most.
Okay, we're coming off of summer camp.
Yes.
But that's important for the kids to stay really engaged before that first day of school.
Absolutely.
Right? So what are the kids, when they come into a rec center, what are they expecting to do?
Interestingly enough, most of the kids really don't have any expectations for when they enter the rec center. And so we have the wonderful opportunity to be able to create an experience for them that brings them back and gets them excited about not just fitness, but as you can tell from the offerings and the good times, recreation is about so much more than just physical activities, but there are craft opportunities as well as, you know, intellectual stimulation and development. Everything that we do really works to develop a holistic individual, which goes to support the city manager's Healthy Norfolk initiatives.
And they can become really good at playing red light, green light.
That we hope so.
And we just need 797 more to show up on September 21st.
Because you're number 800, right,
Bob? I'm going to be it.
Yes.
Because okay. I got this mouth that carries me. It ought to give me something, right?
Yes.
September 21st, 10 to 2.
10 to 2, Tarrallton Park and Tarrallton Community Center.
Great.
We need you to be there.
We'll be there. Red light, red blue, red green.
It's going to be a great time, so come out and play with us. Okay.
Come out and play with us. I never thought I'd have to show that way. Come out and play with us. Super. Thanks a lot.